All right, so what are we going to see and why should people care? Let's check in right now with Guillermo Barro, joins us right now. He's a professor at the University of the Pacific.
So just so our viewers know your background, you actually worked on one of the first programs that will use the James Webb Space Telescope to study these distant galaxies. So what does today's development mean to you?
Well, honestly, I'm mostly relieved because, as you have seen in the video, not only this is an extremely complex telescope, but we decided to fold it multiple times, put it on top of a rocket, launch it, and then it's been unfolding itself like an origami for the last few months, for the last month, actually. And there were a lot of things that could have gone wrong, like 300 silicon points that could have failed and catastrophically end the mission. And none of them went wrong. Everything is going perfect so far. And this is kind of the end of the deployment phase. And we're entering the second phase where they're actually testing the instruments, making sure that we can take high quality pictures and start to collect the data. But the most dangerous part has passed, and the telescope has been able to unfold itself to the final size, which is quite gigantic for a telescope in space. Right? It's the order of 6 meters in diameter. It has a big sound shield that is the size of 2 tennis courts. So it's really, I'm in awe that they were able to unfold a telescope this big in space on its own, and while it's floating away and going away from the Earth.
So it's kind of exhale now, a little relief.
Yeah.
And it's 1,000,000 miles away from Earth in orbit right now. So help people at home understand why this is such a big deal. What can we expect to see once you guys finish fine tuning this in the next several months? Like what are we going to see?
So I think the most important part is that this telescope was conceived to be the successor of Hubble. So we have been using Hubble for the last 30 years, and it completely changed what we know about the universe, the early universe. So it pushed very far into the very beginning of the universe. So we have been able to see the most distant galaxies, and we use the telescopes as time machines. So the most distant galaxies actually send their light to us many billion years ago. But there is a limit to what the Hubble can see because it's mostly working with optical light. So this new telescope is infrared, and so it's able to see farther away in the distance and pushing really, really close to the very first few galaxies formed right after the Big Bang. And this is something that we cannot do from the ground because the atmosphere is fantastic for us. We can breathe, it protects us, keeps us warm, but it's really horrible for astronomical observations because we cannot see the infrared light from the ground. So we really need the space telescopes this big and primed to observing the infrared. So it's a technological challenge, and really we can hope a lot of new groundbreaking science from James Webb as soon as it starts working.
That's a great explanation. Guillermo, thank you so much. We share your excitement with this and can't wait to check back with you as we start getting some of these images.
Absolutely.